Since the release of the previous video on creating a fade-in honeycomb pattern, I've gotten a lot of valuable feedback from the community. I do realize that the method shown was not very efficient, so I went back to the drawing board and further experimented with different workflows. I came to the conclusion that a better way would be to reimagine the honeycomb pattern as a series of extruded cuts instead of a solid extrude. So here is the improved workflow. It is not necessary to watch the previous video before this. Take note that this video will only show how to create the honeycomb pattern and not the full cell phone cover. Looking at the finished model, we have a honeycomb pattern that consists of three bands, fading in and out of the top surface. In your own designs, you will need to decide the angle of these bands and create a construction plane that is normal to the direction of these bands. Create a plane at angle. Select the y-axis. For the case of this example, I will adjust the plane to be 60 degrees to the front plane. Begin a sketch on this new plane. Sketch a rectangle. Begin a midpoint constraint and set the midpoint of the top edge to coincide with the origin. Now, we will need a spline to create the series of wave-like bends. Instead of using a fit point spline, I would encourage you to use a control point spline here. As mentioned previously in a video, patterned instances of fit point splines do not update when a C-spline changes, but control point splines do update. Create a vertical line from the origin. And convert this to a center line. Start a control point spline. Snap the first point to the top edge of the rectangle. Drop the second point somewhere here. Snap the next point to the top of the vertical line. Drop another point here. And lastly, end the spline back on the rectangle. Begin the symmetry constraint. Select this point, followed by the opposite point, and lastly, the center line. Repeat the same for this pair of points. In order to make the spline tangent to the rectangular edge, we can add a horizontal constraint to this control frame. We can dimension the span of the spline by clicking on this point and the center line. Fusion automatically acknowledges that you are trying to dimension the whole span. Dimension this span in the same way. Use a rectangular pattern to create two more instances of the spline. Set distance type to spacing. We are patterning in the horizontal direction, so we should only focus on the parameters here. Set the quantity and distance. For direction type, set to symmetric. The spacing has been adjusted to leave a gap between the splines for the honeycomb pattern to fade in and out. Select select all these profiles and begin an extrude. Set direction to symmetric and adjust the distance. This plate will serve as a raw base from which we will trim off the excess. Create a sketch on the top plane. We will use a rectangle to define the final shape of the design. With this sketch, begin an extrude. Set direction to two sides and set extent to all for both sides so that this extrude will terminate on the top and bottom faces of the previous extrude. Set operation to intersect. This creates an intersecting volume with the previous extrude and in the process removes the excess. Begin a sketch on the top plane. We will now create the starting cell of the honeycomb sketch. Create a circumscribed polygon centered on the origin. And make this side vertical. Create a line that goes from the center to the midpoint of this edge. Create another line that goes from the center to the midpoint of this edge. Convert both these lines to construction. This will serve as directional lines to guide the subsequent pattern. With this profile, we will begin an extrude. Ideally, we would like to use the two object extent option or the extrude all option to perform the cut up to this face, as that will be the design intent. However, both these options require a certain amount of calculation during patterning. In this case, for the sake of patterning efficiency, it would be better to extrude up to an arbitrary distance instead. We just need to make sure to set a distance that exceeds the apex of the spline. Go to Create, Pattern, Rectangular Pattern. Set the type to Features. Select the seed hexagonal cut. For directions, click on the Select box. Let's bring back the sketch and select these two construction lines. Set distance type to spacing. Adjust the parameters accordingly. We should adjust the pattern to exceed what we actually need. Set the compute option to identical. Since the command does not need to calculate each and every pattern instance and look for a face to extrude up to, this greatly speeds up the patterning process. Unlike the original workflow, there is no excess pattern to remove. There are also no multi-body operations involved. I think that this is a good improvement over the previous workflow. Do try this out and let me know your thoughts.